The Gypsy Ball is well underway, where young gypsy princesses come in the hope of finding true love. Mum Jacy is determined to find her daughter Puff a suitor who is part of their community.
Am I good?
Yeah.
But the thought of marriage has left 14-year-old Puff feeling overwhelmed.
I was feeling sort of awkward. My intention for going there was not to find a man. It was to have a good night.
She was beautiful, but she was uncomfortable.
Seeing her daughter on edge forces Jacy to make a decision.
I think I just brought her a little too early, and maybe I should have waited a year or so.
My brother's being so overbearing all night, I just really need my own space.
Her brave admirer, Dylan, spots an opportunity to talk to her alone.
Dylan from before comes to chat, and I'm hoping that my brothers are busy in the party or they'll just scare him away again. I'm sorry about what happened in there with my brothers. They're just too overprotective.
Honestly, it comes down to what you want, not what they want.
Yeah, you understand, yeah.
To be honest, I'm not scared of the brothers. I'm not gonna let that stop me.
But the young couple are soon interrupted.
Selena. Dude.
I walk outside, I see my sister sitting with this dude. What part of stay away from her does he understand?
We have rules, right?
Yeah.
Why can't you go by him?
Can you just let me have space for a second? I mean, he's a good guy. Can you at least try and get to know him?
Hold up.
Fuck.
Before a boxing match can begin, Mom Hazel gets involved.
After everything happened tonight, my daughter Selena haven't had a chance to speak with the boy.
Give her a little bit of space, okay? She's not doing it but sitting here talking.
If this Dylan is the right one, he got my vote. After my two boys beat his ass and he came back for more, I gotta give him respect for that.
Just don't disrespect my daughter.
You guys got no worries. I promise, just chatting.
That's all it better be.
This Bella the Ball bagged herself a true Prince Charming.
Ah, you're so pretty.
This is our one chance at finding true love with a nice gypsy man, and my sister cannot ruin this for us.
Older sister Lindsay shares her anger with her friend Emily.
They're not acting very ladylike.
I don't believe that you let them get away with what you're letting them get away with.
What am I supposed to do with them?
My two little sisters are so selfish. They didn't even think about me. I was there to find love at the ball too, and instead it was all about them.
Oh my God.
Uh-uh!
What the fuck? Oh my God!
They both started kissing them.
That's not okay.
I am furious because if these two boys don't work out, no good gypsy man's gonna want them. Right now, I'm seeing red.
After years of being controlled by their older sister, Lauren and Jessica have had enough.
Me and Lauren weren't gonna take Lindsay's shit anymore. We were gonna give her a piece of our minds.
We want your approval, but it's time for you to have trust in us, to have faith. Can we at least go
You can go
on
dance
a date?
With...
Me too.
With a chaperone, yes you can.
Why do I have a chaperone?
I'm 27 years old. I don't need Lindsay to tell me what to do. I think I know how to date.
After tonight, I plan on seeing him, whether y'all approve or not.
Lindsay, do you approve of Josh? Can you please at least get to know him?
Drop it.
She's
the
party.
Get the
fuck off. Are you serious?
We're tired of her controlling our lives, and we're not going to let her ruin our one chance at meeting a nice gypsy man.
Don't you walk away,
no,
Jessica.
No.
She wanted us to meet gypsy men. We did. We liked them. And this has been a great opportunity for us to actually find real love.
As the fairy tale comes true for some, loveless gypsy Lolo is all alone. Her chaperone Peter has been at the bar all night.
I was just mad. I'm like, am I just not gonna find nobody? Is he not gonna help me out?
Peter, come on me!
I'm sorry. I need to find somebody or I'm not gonna have a chance.
If Pete does not find me a guy, I'm gonna go find a guy myself.
For the first time in her life, Lolo breaks a strict Ludar rule and heads to the dance floor on her own.
I traveled 900 miles to come to this ball and I'm gonna have me some fun. You know, the clock was ticking. You know, I was getting nervous. My heart was beating. And then I see this boy, and he just, like, caught my eye. His name is Darian. He's handsome, he's tall, he's really hot, and, you know, he had a great personality. I felt like, you know, my dream was finally going to come true.
But before Lolo can get to know Darian better, brother Pete spots them.
I came in and saw Lolo dancing with somebody. That made me pissed. And I told her not to dance with nobody without my permission, and she broke our rule.
It's a standoff as both men refuse to back down.
I spoke to him, and I didn't like him. He wasn't good enough for my sister.
Within seconds, the gypsy ball turns into a gypsy brawl.
Oh no, is this really gonna happen right now when I finally get to dance with somebody?
You like that?
Before the fight can escalate, Darian is dragged away by his mother, Roxy.
I was having a great time all night until he tried to swing on me. He swung on me for no reason. He would have lost because he ran away.
Darian's departure leaves Lolo at a loss.
I don't know where he went. I've been waiting for this day for like 23 years, so my dream has to come true, and my brother ruined it today.
I really liked him, Peter.
You broke the rules.
I know I did.
You should not dance with no one.
Well, you were
snacking
on your job.
No, I
you
was not.
You didn't bring nobody up to me.
I wanted my happily ever after. He just cut it short, like it was just done.
There you go. I'm sorry.
This fairy tale just came crashing down.